there like a cut, take, take one?
Horrible.
Shuffling right now is trending.
What
is this?
This is worse than a dick pic.
As our creamy call. Just thinking about it.
What is up, creamers? Welcome to Get Creamy, the segment where we interview and talk to people who are really cool and do cool things and figure out how they do them. Today on Get Creamy, we have Brigitte, who is a shuffler. That's right, she dances. Do you know what shuffling is? Well, it was originally called the Melbourne Shuffle. I don't know much else other than that, but Brigitte is gonna teach us. So let's go learn to shuffle. We're on our way to this shuffling tutorial, and I'm here at the supermarket trying to get some baby powder because I read that you need baby powder to be a dancer and to do shuffling. I have no idea where the baby powder is.
Hit the self-checkout. Bam.
No, I don't got a coupon. So we got the baby powder. It's a lot. And I also have packing tape in the car. This is gonna be good. I think we're gonna have the moves. Alright, so here we are. We're ready to learn how to shuffle.
Hello.
What's up?
Hey, hey.
I got my baby powder and my scotch tape.
This is it.
Is this where we learn how to shuffle?
Let's go.
Alright, alright.
Hey, thank you for doing this shuffling tutorial.
Yeah,
I looked up shuffling and they said that we needed body powder and scotch tape or packing tape for the bottom of your shoes. Do we need this?
So, okay, yes and no. In your everyday shuffles, probably no, but let's just say you're in a dark, dingy, dirty ass motherfucking club and there's beer or drinks spilled everywhere, it's really sticky, it's gonna be hard to dance. And shuffling is all about an illusion, right? So
yeah.
If you're sticking to the floor, that's not any illusion that anyone wants to look at. But the second you put down some baby powder, get those floors nice and squeaky, you can glide effortlessly, which is really great because that's what we want to mimic. And we do that no matter what, whether it's a sticky floor or not, because that's the dance style.
Gosh.
But it's gonna be easier for you. Easier on your body, less energy, expenditure, all that. The tape is also the same thing. So if you don't have baby powder, maybe you put tape on the bottom of your shoes, and obviously you stick the sticky side to your shoes, duh. So you're not sticking to the floor. And that way—
Do you think I need to do it now?
No. These are beautiful wood floors, so you probably don't need any of that. But if you want to slip and slide, I mean, we can, at the end of it, we can throw some baby powder on.
Okay,
but
okay.
For the time being, let's just warm up our ankles because that's where we want to start most of our movement. We want ankle mobility. So I'm gonna have you just do some calf raises and then we will move forward to rocking side to side. There's a lot of compression that happens in shuffling. You're slamming your feet and your knees down on the ground. All right, now rock side to side. Really focus in your ankles so that we are increasing some of the space in our joints. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It is a workout. It really is. So, a little mind muscle game. Let's do some figure eights. So you'll go off to the side.
Whoa.
And then this way, yeah, yeah, yeah. We're working on movement here. And then, yep, reverse it. That's just in order to prime our body for this type of movement because we will be raising our legs. Let's just get them up. Once you've got that, we'll step it up a notch, do some high knees. And then we'll get into it. All right.
This is great.
Yeah?
This is an awesome workout.
We're gonna be going through the running man, which in itself is straightforward because it looks like you are running in place. A lot of people have seen it. Can you do it though? Probably not.
I can.
Exactly. So
not,
that's why
not,
you're
not
here.
Me.
That's why you're here. Alrighty. So the running man starts off and it's really a two-part movement where we always start off with our transitionary kind of form. This is the UTP, as I like to call it, with the shuffle circle, and this is your universal transition point. This is key. Moving forward, no, 90 degree bend, high knees. This is where you want to be in between each move. This is where you are on the hi-hat if you're listening to electronic music.
Okay.
So on the baseline, you'll come down and the foot that's up will land flat, and your back foot will almost go into this lunge so that you're creating a wide base.
Uh-huh.
So come back up into UTP. This time when you land in a lunge right below you. Perfect. So all your weight right now should be centered right beneath you.
Uh-huh.
You're almost leaning a little bit over your knee. That's for balance. But you don't want to be looking down. You always want to keep your audience in mind, chest up, be proud. Exactly.
Okay.
You got this, you got this.
Keep the audience in mind, yeah.
Audience in mind. Chest up, be proud. Now we're gonna go back into UTP on our left. So jump up into that crane pose, left leg comes up. Yes, beautiful. So balance is key. Of course, we're gonna be doing this much quicker, but for now, take it slow. Let's land in our lunge position on this leg. On one. Perfect, lower. So when you do this, keep your back leg straight, beautiful. And of course, there's a little bit of space here because, you know, we're landing mostly with our weight on the front half of our foot there.
Okay.
Now, evenly distributed here on the front so that we're balanced. And you're just gonna continue that motion and I'll give you some counts. So this will be our and, come back up again. Yes, exactly. And then one. Back.
And.
Two.
And.
So two-step movement here. Let's turn this way. Let's turn this way so that you can see more of what's happening here.
Okay.
Yeah. So come up into your UTP. Let's do it with our right leg first. And then we'll land on one. And come up.
And.
Two. Down. No.
Oh.
Honey, what the fuck was that? Alrighty, so.
Hey, there might be kids watching.
But when you speed this up, it might make a little bit more sense. And let me just show you. It would be one, and two, and three, and four, and five, and six. So notice how my back leg is always sliding back in order for me to create the base. Once you get that movement down, you can continue with that over and over again. We'll bring in our arms to make it a little easier. Just as if we were running in spot, do a little run in spot, a little jog.
Okay.
Notice how your arms are moving side to side. This we want to emulate in our running man. So
okay.
When we do this, opposite arm, opposite leg will come up.
Okay.
Right? When we land, it'll stay there, but then we're gonna switch opposites. And this motion will help you come up. Down, up.
Oh.
So, here.
This, wow.
You got this? Okay, slow it down. Let's add some counts to that. Here, opposite arm comes up, right? And we're gonna go 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That was trying, but like I said, it's a high energy movement. It takes some practice. Just keep in mind that it is a two-step move, so you're always counting your ands. One, and two, and three, and four.
Okay.
Okay, so now that we have those movements down, we're gonna break it down to a T-step, which is very low energy compared to your running man. It's more like a V than a T, but we call it a T because when you come down, your feet are lined up in this very perpendicular shape where they're coming together at almost a 90 degree, causing you to look like a T or a V. So when you start, you won't start in this position. This is the one.
This is
the
like
two.
First position. This is like a demi-plié.
Yeah, so it's not something, you know, that we're gonna stay in a long time and there's a lot of variation, but this is the foundation of a T-step. Now, the in-between, the ands, you have to come up just like in our running man. This is our UTP, remember, transitioning. So we come here and we go down one. When this foot comes down simultaneously, this foot will open up into that V shape. So there's a lot of foot heel movement going on where you have to shift your weight from the back of your foot to the front of your foot.
Okay.
So a lot of thinking. This is why it's complicated, but it's easier on your energy. So here, UTP, we're gonna cut, and in this point, your toe will most likely be pointed more inwards like a pigeon toe kind of thing. You're coming in, You're gonna come down on one and open everything up. So this will slide open. The way I can do that is by lifting my heel ever so slightly and landing. So weight is here, push this inwards. So we're here, heel comes in. Here.
Oh, heel comes in.
Yep. So we're turned, toes are turned together, and now toes turn out. Yes!
Oh, wow, I just did it, guys. I just did it.
Yes, again, that was beautiful. Okay, all right. Don't get carried away.
I feel like I'm in Dance Dance Revolution right now. Like, this is some serious stuff. I just scored like 1,000 points or something.
Seriously, now I'm gonna make it harder though. So we're leveling up.
Level up, let's level up.
Level up. So this is obviously, again, we're starting here, you come down. This is just one variation. This is your basic foundational tea step. From here, we're gonna add sauce. Right? Everyone
sauce.
Likes sauce.
I want the sauce.
All the
I like sauce.
Sauce.
I want the cream. How do we get the cream in this?
I will show you how we get the cream on top. So,
yeah.
Again, this is your basic. Notice how I came down now with a toe upwards. This adds a little bit of flavor.
I like things that go up.
Right? Yeah. Everyone does. So, here, this is one. Yeah. Now, let's add a back step to that. So, again, into our transition point. This time, we're going to come back. And in this case, notice how my heel still comes out. Exactly. You're going to almost be stacked. We're going to come back into UTP, so we're up in our pigeon toe, and then we can go forward again. Now let's add counts to that. So start
one.
Here. This our and.
Oh,
our one is always when we hit the ground.
Okay, and.
So and one.
One.
And let's go back.
Two.
And three.
And
four. Let's stop there. Now that we have a back and front, let's add a side step so we can almost pull it into this little circle. Our side step is gonna be a little off to the side. So a little bit more obtuse, you're a little bit wider here. I like to bend my knee on the one I'm standing on so that I have a bigger base.
Okay.
Now this will help when you have a lot of movement and you have a lot of momentum, so you're not tipping over. If you're upright, it's really hard to keep balance.
Yeah.
But if you're a little bit looser in your knees and open up your base, you have more to work with. So. We are going to introduce a little pattern of T-steps so we can use back, side, front. We go back, and that's your back T-step. No, back T-step. So remember, your heel's gonna pop forward. We're gonna go back. Yes! And then up in UTP and side.
Side.
Come out on your heel.
Oh, so I'm like really like moving on this like one.
You're moving on one over and over and over again. Yes. And you're sweeping the floor.
Is that it?
No.
Did I just do it?
Almost. But we're gonna use our heel. We're gonna use our heel more. We're gonna get more involved here with some little toe flexes. Exactly.
Are my legs bent?
This one's bent. This one's straight as a board. Yep.
Okay.
Real stiff. Now, this adds just a little bit more dynamic and it highlights your movement. So from here, let's go up into UTP again and let's come forward. Yep. Time you're always doing this in between because we're still T-stepping.
Okay.
The reason we are doing that is because essentially I would be moving to the side and that's how I travel. Right? So.
I travel by airplanes.
You know what? This is slower. It works. So we're going to do a back step, a side, a front, and come back into our UTP so that we're priming ourselves for our next move. But I want you to get this down first because I'm building a rock for you. Very simple rock, but this is really the foundation of what a Melbourne shuffle is.
Okay.
So we really want to hone on that.
Okay.
This is just a basic way.
So why don't you show everybody how to do it then?
Okay.
I can't do this. Let me see what it's all about.
Alrighty, so we were going over a really basic rock where we're combining three T-steps and we're gonna follow it up with one running man. So there's a really set pattern and it's really technical in that sense, but once you get that down, you can repeat it on your right and your left in a loop. And it becomes this illusion that you're floating on the floor. Now, doing it with our pattern, if I were to count us out, starting in UTP, we go 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So notice how I was able to finish a whole 8 count in 2 kind of rocks back and forth. This goes really nicely with the music. So if you're dancing to electronic music, you can count on the bars, you can come down on the bass line and let the melody really move your upper body, which is one thing we didn't talk too much about. But it comes in later when you're more tenured and you understand how it all flows together. So let's just go over a couple different variations of rocks so that you can see, because that T-step I was talking about is super technical. And people really don't explore it enough until way later in their dance exploration. So that was a really simple 3x1. Let's do a 2x1 pattern. That is 2 T-steps and 1 running man. Still a rock. In this case, I might go here, here, running man, out, chop, running man, out, chop, running man, out, chop, running man. And then I can follow it up with just running man, like we started off with. But notice how there's a lot of crossing of my feet. If I wanted to actually travel, I could do that too. But essentially, it is all about creating an illusion. And you're using your feet to travel across the floor, as well as add that little extra cream on top with all the little nuances that you can. Flick of the wrist, flick of the heel, whatever you want to call it.
Tell me how you got into shuffling.
Okay, well, easy peasy. So, you know when you're at a show or an event and you're really vibing and you see everyone else having the best time of their life and you're not on drugs, but you want to have the best time of your life? I found that shuffling was that answer for me because I wanted to move, I wanted high energy, but I wanted expression. Mm-hmm. And I wasn't a drinker. So for me, something that really involved my body in almost a taxing way wasn't something that was gonna scare me away. Mm-hmm. I had always danced my whole life, but never formally in the sense that like I've danced ballet or hip hop for the past 6 years, 7 years, and I'm just a natural. It wasn't that way. I needed to find something that I could teach myself. Mm-hmm. Something where I loved the music carried me already, and something that was kind of technical because I have a brain that really understands technical things. And so shuffling was that. And what started off as, like I said, just the running man and the T-step, which is your foundation, ended up opening so many more doors for me to then explore movement through. And really, it became almost an extension of myself. It is this unspoken language that just flows out of you when you allow it to. And when you've tapped into enough, when you have enough tools, you can build your dream house. So my flow is that dream house, okay? And I collected enough tools over the years.
Yeah, yeah. Like how long when you started to dance did it take you to be good enough to then show another person how to do this. Like what was the length of that learning curve?
Wow. Well, my learning curve was long because, mind you, I taught myself. And back then, listen, shuffling right now is trending. It's trending everywhere. You go on TikTok, everyone's dancing. You go on Instagram, you'll see people dancing. But when I started, it wasn't like that. There was YouTube, and YouTube had been around for, I don't know, 10, 15 years with shuffle content on there. So there were old videos. That was strictly Melbourne style dancing. And now shuffling has evolved into hybrid forms of it where you have shapes that are very much more like footwork heavy, they're bouncy, it's done to a lot of house music versus shuffling, which is done to things that, yes, you can dance to house, but people originally danced to hardstyle and trance. So mm-hmm. your BPM is up 128 to 144 maybe. Super, super high, intense cardio. I'm not shy in that sense. So I remember posting my first video and it was literally like a year or I don't know, a couple months, maybe 6, 7, 8 months into myself teaching, you know, myself how to do the running man, the T-step, and then a little extra. I did start with shape, so I had a little bit of footwork there, but
shapes? Like
shapes are
squares,
like, no, triangles, so they call it cutting circles. Shapes, but essentially you're making shapes on the ground. So yes, it is. You have to think about it like that. You're doing a lot of geometric hard angles in your feet. And the more you watch people do this, which is why the social media component has been such an amazing tool, not just to connect and watch other people, but to connect with people who are more experienced. So I started to watch and learn from people who knew a little bit more than me. I met this amazing guy who had been shuffling for 12 years and passed on a lot of knowledge from the very underground rave kind of origination mm-hmm. of this dance, which really helped me fine-tune my own style. Because it is technical, I wanted to learn how to do it the right way before I added my cream on top.
Your cream on top, yeah, that's right.
So
you have to learn the rules before you can break them.
Exactly.
In almost any industry or any profession or any art form.
Exactly. You got to respect the whole thing before you can come and fuck shit up, essentially.
So you have a shuffling business.
I do, yes. So,
entrepreneur right here.
Take
notes. Ladies and gentlemen, creamers. Creamers, that's what people who watch Cream on Top, you guys are
creamy
called.
Creamy just thinking about it.
You guys are creamers. So you have a business.
I do have a business. I started teaching people how to shuffle together with my business partner, Tyler, who lives in Florida.
Uh-huh.
So states away, but we started talking on FaceTime a lot, and we decided, because at that point, and this was about almost 3 years ago. In September, it's our 3-year anniversary. Oh. And we were essentially the first shuffle-based dance school instructors that formalized kind of a program. We started building out a platform online. So we have our own website that has almost, I want to say, 100 step-by-step tutorials on different footwork that either we have picked up over the years from amazing dancers across, you know, the world, or it is combos that we put together ourselves. So there's a lot of original content that we have curated or that we have produced, but also curated from the community.
Mm-hmm.
In that sense, we wanted to proliferate all of this amazing content and information that was kept in the underground. We wanted to bring it out into the light and really show it off in the same way that hip hop had been done. That's a street-based dance. It
sure.
was not something that's done on stage like ballet is, but we felt that this is a dance that can be more than what it is, and we wanted the world to see it. And now you have platforms like TikTok that are just blowing up, and this type of exposure is almost just what we needed. And it's a little bit scary because when you, especially with shuffling, being that it is such an underground type of dance and we have a really strong community around it, we're very protective over it and we want people to learn it the right way.
Mm-hmm.
So that's another reason we wanted to start the Shuffle Circle. We wanted people to have the strongest, most accurate shuffle foundation, and then from there on, bring in all of the cream. We wanted all of that extra flair to come in after the fact.
Mm-hmm.
Like we just said, having that strong foundation, knowing what's right from wrong before going in and making it your own is really critical. So yeah, we started teaching people how to shuffle, and because not everybody lives where we are, we opened up our borders and did a lot of virtual lessons. This was mm-hmm. pre-COVID. So
pre-COVID.
We were already on that train 3 years ago. My first student was in Portugal, and I taught her from Hawaii over FaceTime. So it was just like these types of connections we could never have made without technology.
Uh-huh.
But also because it is such a nuanced style of dance, people came to us. We did not have to market ourselves because we were essentially the first ones out there offering it. So that really helped set us up, especially for things like COVID. So once this kicked in and people were scrambling to offer their services virtually 6 feet away from people, we already had that up and going.
Mm-hmm.
And we kicked off with big group classes because we had been used to teaching. We would travel to Chicago, Miami, Orlando, Dallas, anywhere, and teach in large group settings, and we couldn't do that anymore. So we're like, well, how do we do this? So we started doing a lot of group classes online.
There you go.
And we expanded ourselves into more choreo-based dancing because that's easy to transfer versus freestyle. Everyone wants to learn how to freestyle and flow, which is essentially the pinnacle of your dance. You don't want to have to think about the next move. It should just come to you. But again, you need the tools. And so we started off teaching a lot of choreo. We then decided, let's scale it back down again. Yes, offer choreo, but let's really, just like we do in our one-on-one private lessons, let's really feed them the information they need to then go off and build their own.
Cool.
So, yeah.
So if someone wanted to take a lesson with you guys, how would they find you?
Right. They would either follow me on Instagram. I am Brigitte, B-R-I-G-G-Y-D. Or you could follow The Shuffle Circle. Straightforward, theshufflecircle.com also works. That is our website. It is our platform. You can become a member for free. But you can also subscribe to our videos so that you get new content every month. We have a lot of choreo that's free on our blog. We have concepts that are broken down for free as well. So we're offering a variety of information at different price points, different types of engagement levels. Mm-hmm. But essentially, if you want to really dive head first, we always recommend the private lessons so that we can tailor your learning to whatever style that you are trying to pursue, because there are so many different avenues you can go once you get your foundation down.
Amazing.
Yeah.
All right. Here at Cream on Top, we ask all of our creamers a series of questions. So if you've watched some of our previous interviews, you've probably heard some questions, but might've been a little different. What's your favorite word?
Ooh. Oh my God. I've never been asked that. I don't think I have a favorite. Who said we had to pick a favorite word? How long have you thought about a favorite word? What's your favorite word?
Nobody's asked me, but I have thought of it.
Yeah, yeah.
My favorite word is badly.
Badly.
Badly, because if you want something badly, that's really wanting it.
Yeah, yeah.
Like if you want someone badly enough.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay, you're going to go get them. Or if you want some material possession, but material possessions, we're all nomadic. So what's a material possession? We don't need those.
Badly. Okay. Well, I'm going to think about that question and I'll just come back to you.
Okay. Well, it ties into your next question.
Oh, shit.
What's your least favorite word?
Ooh. No, I love these questions, but these are like ones that I would have to actually sit down and truly think about. You know, I do like the word. This goes back to the first question.
Okay.
I love the word frolicking. I don't know why.
That's a nice
word. I love
to
frolic. I love to just like be free through a little prairie, maybe running around nude. I don't know, sunshining. All of that sounds amazing.
Hippie Beach, Austin, Texas.
There we go. Nobody ever.
I stalked you on Instagram. I found. I see the places you go.
I love a good little nude beach. You catch me frolicking. But then on the flip side, I guess definitely don't like the word ointment. It's gross. It doesn't sound good. It's associated with a rash, probably an unidentifiable one.
Nobody always unidentifiable.
In a weird place that you don't want to show off.
sending photos to your doctor friends that you do not want anybody to see.
What is this?
This is worse than a dick pic. Is when you get a rash and you're sending all your friends like, yo, don't know what this is. Do you know what it is? Can you help me out? Like,
don't come near me.
am I scared? Should I be scared?
It's not a good word.
What turns you on?
Some really dark, deep techno in a sweaty club where you can feel the bass just undulating through you. Makes you creamy.
Okay. All right, we'll take that answer.
Right there.
What turns you off?
Off? Ooh, some like top 40 radio songs at a club that is too packed with way too many people who are too fucked up. That turns me off.
So you love COVID.
Oh my God.
You're like, everywhere's empty. Don't have to see nobody. Exactly, no spaces.
Exactly. The only thing is you don't get the creaminess because there ain't no club bumping, no techno. can't be sweating around people.
We met at the single party in Austin that happened. Like there was one
where there
weekend.
Was techno and it was undulating and there was cream. It was the perfect.
And we saw Sarah Landry.
We saw Miss Sarah.
And right after this interview, I'm on my way to go interview Sarah. Mm-hmm. Funny thing. What's your favorite curse word?
Fuck. It's just so applicable. It goes, it's a positive one, a negative one, it's an adjective, it's a verb, all the things, the whole spectrum wrapped up in one little neat bow.
What trend do you love?
I love this female empowerment trend, not even trend, train. We're just blowing full steam ahead. We are taking over the world, okay?
It's not stopping.
It's not stopping. You get in our way. You
do not get in the way of women right now. Absolutely not.
Bulldozed. Yeah, that's the trend I like.
What trend do you hate?
Oh my God. I hate the underboob trend. I'm all for female
empowerment. Is that a trend?
Okay, I went off on my story the other day. So people be wanting to show off their assets and I'm all about it. I'm all about it. But what happened to not trying so hard? Like, where's the side boob? Where's the cleavage? People be pulling up their little tops just to show off about a half inch of underboob when we all know the minute that you stretch or jump in the pool, those babies flying out. It should be over soon. It's been going on for a little bit. Summer's almost at the end of it.
What is the first thing you think of when you hear cream on top?
I think of a really just like a big bowl of strawberries and sugar with whipped cream just piled high and then a little cherry. That's what I think.
Guys, thank you for joining us in this shuffling tutorial with Brigitte. Mm-hmm. Let them know again how to follow you.
Follow me on Instagram. I am Brigitte, or you can follow me at The Shuffle Circle or head on over to theshufflecircle.com for private one-on-one lessons.
And all of that information is in the show notes. And if you want to learn how to shuffle, go take one of her classes or follow her on Instagram and watch her videos. The girl's got moves. And we will see you next time, creamers.
Yeah.
In the meantime, get creamy. Mwah! Creamers, thank you for joining us. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. If you hated it, give us a thumbs down. If you wanna see more, give us a subscribe. If you wanna tell us what to do, leave a comment. And if you wanna see us singing in the shower, follow us on Instagram. Get creamy.